And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Let's Play Assassin's Creed Syndicate, Part 23. In the last one, we liberated the entire Strand. And now, as we return to our hideout, we will be accepting a letter for Jacob Fry. I feel as though we're finally getting to the last stretches of the main game. Which is exciting. We've been on Syndicate for quite a while, and I cannot wait to play through the Jack the Ripper DLC and move on to Odyssey. Or, not Odyssey, I'm so sorry. Origins.
A letter. For me.
A letter for you, Jacob. Of course we are, Clara. Oh, yes. Oh, so where are we going to be starting Season 7? That is my mistake. All is fair in politics. Jacob and Evie have killed two of Crawford Sterick's agents, Philip Twopenny and Lucy Thorne, but the Templars are far from defeated. A conspiracy to assassinate the Prime Minister takes Jacob to the Houses of Parliament, and despite Evie's triumph over Lucy Thorne, the quest for the Shroud takes a dramatic turn.
Dear Mr. Sterick, men hired. Strike tomorrow. Disraeli's death will stall Corrupt Practices Act indefinitely. Gladstone will be far more pliable. May the father, etc., etc., be. So Sterick's got his finger in politics, has he? I need to enter the Sinopian Club and find out who B is.
Tread delicately around Parliament.
As if I don't usually.
Your indiscretion at the Bank of England caused British currency to nearly collapse.
Nearly is the operative word. Speaking of collapses, what of the key you found that unlocks very little?
Henry took it for research. I am confident that the vault is ours.
Nearly ours, Evie. Nearly. A letter. For me?
One, two, none for Jacob. Nope, there it is. Playing politics. Ha. We started with Evie last time. Unbreaking the bank. Why not continue with that? We've been very, very...
It's a difficult world, I find. So much injustice.
Preoccupied with Jacob here. So why not? Let Evie have a go. And with this... We're at last level 10. At the very peak of our abilities. There we go. And Outfit Master Assassin Detection Speed. Ooh. Yes. Soon. The Chimera, Light and Dark Cane Sword. Ooh, Eagle Splendor Kukri. The Night Terror Cane. You could say this cane is a real nightmare. Yes, I could, and I will. They could both use this. They could both use all of them, actually. Okay. She looks so good in her Master Assassin outfit.
Wait there while I chop.
Let's unbreak the bank. Shall we?
Easy. Easy. There you go.
Freddie. Evie pays a visit to the center of London after Jacob's assassination of two people.
Done this time.
The newspapers are all over Twopenny's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Twopenny's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help.
No more exploitation!
Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent nearby. Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Abelard.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Abelline.
I have the utmost faith in you, Miss Fry.
The Abelline Constitution. There you are.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
The counterfeiters.
Heard about the rioting at the bank?
They can riot all they like. We won't be giving back those plates.
Of course, what difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on
to know about it. Since we've got the printing plates, it's all real cash.
Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting.
You are too
much. Nothing to do with us.
I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. He acts in haste and repents not at all.
Come on, you silly man.
Oh,
Locked down.
Yes, sir.
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
Absolutely, sir.
Someone's gonna get quite the fright.
Now to sneak these back into the bank.
Reaching the Bank of England, willing to let the rioters in. I'm sure Freddie's gonna love that.
Thank you.
There. As if they were never taken.
The area.
Ladies and gentlemen,
home room?
Is that absurd?
Well, the London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.
And there we go. M1877 Lightning. And then a change of plans.
Please tell me again where we are going.
I found a letter from the Prince Consort among Lucy Thorne's research, marked with the same insignia as your key, dated 1847.
1847.
The same year the Prince began renovations to Buckingham Palace.
You think he added a vault for the shroud?
And since there is no map of the palace with the room marked Secret Vault.
Your Highness, may I present Miss Evie Fry. Miss Fry, Maharaja Duleep Singh.
A pleasure, Your Highness.
My friend, the plans you asked for have been removed.
Removed? By whom?
Crawford Starrick, or someone employed by him. Yes, I thought you might recognize the name. I know where they are, but it is heavily guarded.
That part will not be a problem.
I thought not.
We're going to need a plan.
I can provide a distraction for the guards while you find a safe way inside.
Oh, really?
For you, Evie? Certainly.
Well, once I'm inside, I'll find someone who knows where the papers are stored.
And we will meet back on the train.
Be careful.
Thank you.
That's an intruder! The rock show is here!
That's not them.
Doing here? Come on! She won't escape! I see her!
That's an intruder! Don't let her win this fight!
Looks like I have to ask someone where the plans are.
They've taken him.
Taken who?
The man, dressed like you. The guards dragged him off.
Henry, the plans you stole, where are they?
I don't know anything about that.
The plans, the mission.
sometimes you gotta find your heart, Evie.
You're some of Clara's children.
They took Mr. Henry. We couldn't stop them.
I bit one of them good, though.
They dragged him off in a red carriage.
They won't get far, though. One wheel looked like it was about ready to fall off. You can see the cart tracks. It looks all wobbly-like.
Come on now. That's it. That cart's been run off the road. They must be driving quickly. Here now, and destruction of public property. I must be on the right track.
He's an assassin. How much more adult can he get? Why did you bring him here? The man's an assassin. We didn't want him getting away before you had a chance to question him now, did we?
I sent someone to move the architectural plans. Do you have them?
Did they hurt you?
I'm fine.
Let's go.
Time to escape.
What about the plans?
The plans are lost.
Evie, I'm sorry.
Just concentrate on escaping, please. Get Miss Nightingale to look at that. I must find the vault before Starrick secures the shroud.
We'll talk to the Maharaja again.
I will talk to the Maharaja. You will get your head looked at.
I'm sorry my capture hasn't done your plans.
You'd be safer on the train.
Even if you find the vault, you can't just walk into Buckingham Palace alone.
I won't be alone. I'll see you back at the train, Mr. Green.
Trouble in Paradise. Ah, there it is. Playing politics. Yes. We're gonna have to go ahead and cut the episode a bit early today. But it was good to play as Evie. I'll have to go back and figure out whatever they meant with Mr. Green's distractions. But you live and you learn.
But Helga wants the child to have a German.
When we return, we will be seeing what Jacob is doing up on this rooftop. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you so much for tuning in today. And until next time, always keep telling stories.